for Savage Devil is alive. Recording according to the numbers on the front of the camera. Let's go for a ride on the Savage. We're not going real fast, and I'm not going to go playing at all. As you can see, I'm just in my work shirt and work pants, put some gloves on, got my helmet on. It's been quite a while since this one's been alive. Now, hell, technically it was alive and still running when I tore it down. It just, it was slapping pretty loud, and I actually tore it down because I needed to do the front end as well as the motor. So I figured, oh, screw it, I'll just do it all at once. Went ahead and tore it down, and it sat, focused on other things. Go up Blue Ridge a little ways. Gotta put some miles on this thing, break in this new piston, seat the new rings in with the cylinder, and I gotta keep constantly kind of fluctuating the power demand on it. Ask it for more, ask it for less. So that the RPMs are varying. That's kind of how I like to break one in. I don't go crazy with being super gentle and babying them, but I don't like to let them just sit at one RPM range at the same intensity for too long. Fluctuate. I like to fluctuate. The idea behind that, and my, you know, thinking is, I let those rings seat in at varying degrees of demand out of it. So they're seating in at all angles, so to speak. Blue Ridge Highway a ways. front end damn sure feels a whole lot more stable. Thing literally felt like there were a couple of beyond al dente elbow noodles up front for forks the last time I rode it and decided it was time to go ahead and tear it down. It was actually the ride when I went over Blood Mountain to go to Cleveland to go pick up the Vulcan, that Kawasaki Vulcan tank that I modified to fit on the Shadow. And it started kind of getting a little squirrely on the way over, but on the way back, it was kind of terrifying. It was dark, and it was starting to get foggy, and this thing was all over the fucking road, like absolutely uncontrollable. Skeena Gap. I don't think I've ridden Skeena Gap. Kind of miss this whole thing. That was a pretty little farm though. Nice and tight during that turn. Hell, before the damn seals blew and I lost all the oil, the thing would like chirp and skip around the corner if I was leaning in a little bit, just a little bit. Huh. And I just kind of got used to it, you know, and learned to deal with it. Expecting, oh, it's just a fucking savage. That's how they're supposed to ride. Nope, I guess not. Because that was leaps and bounds better. It turned. And didn't hop across the road. Oh wow, man, he's done a lot of work at that place. I didn't realize we were so far out already. It's a buddy of mine's place. Hadn't been out here in a while. Since the last time I had to fix a broken piece of equipment. view. Oh, so pretty. Road patches. Damn, this thing is actually pretty freaking stable. With good freaking seals and fresh oil, right amount of it up front. I don't ever remember it riding this easy. It's smooth and stable. Huh? Feel this piston seating in. Can hear it audibly. The report's getting a little sharper. As it seats in a little bit, it'll actually gain a little bit of compression. But that final little bit, it makes a difference. And you can definitely notice a difference in performance once it's all the way there. It's a fine line too, is once you overheat it and start melting the piston, boom, you lose like half, two-thirds to half of your potential is all you got left. Backfire farts. Smoky Gap. Trucks I'll take care of. I'll just point it as it passes by. Now this one, I don't mind running off into the woods. Might just keep on going once the pavement ends. I'm definitely not in the gear for going out and playing on the gravel, but so I probably shouldn't. Isn't bad. There's not a whole lot of gravel. That's fun. This gets hairy. That's fun. Riding in the woods, riding in the woods. Watch for bears and big feets. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. That's freaking awesome, y'all. Just wham, we're out in the middle of the fucking national forest. With actual roads, we don't gotta worry about hitting trees. Just watch the rocks. Keep an eye out for bears crossing the road. You come up here and be easy and just enjoy it, or come up here and tear ass around, or whatever. And there I go, tear-assing around a little bit. You can just go off into the forest if you want to. And I'm gonna stop right here and smoke me a cigarette. Let the bikes chill out for a little bit. Who says you need an ATV bike to do ATV shit? Now, on a more capable machine, if you wanted to, you could just go right off the trail. Go right out in the fucking forest. Okay, it's a stupid Old Spice commercial. Yeah, that pissed the seating in nice now. and laurel's all blooming. Never been that smooth. Be careful, I don't remember where my freaking lean point is when my pegs start to scrape. It's been too long. See if I can catch that on camera. A decent one. Nope. They can turn inside its own asshole. I'll give them that. I'm maneuverable little fucks. Fun. Savage is back to life. Hope y'all enjoyed the ride.
Welcome, my son. Welcome to the machine.